Magic tea. Hello and welcome to Sunday Outside. I'm in Ravenscourt Park next to a big chunky tree, and you may hear the dawn chorus of that of parrots, because that's what we have in London now. We have the chatter of parrots in the morning. And impressive and oppressive thing is, like an idiot, I thought I was going to get internet in Ravenscourt Park, so I don't have any of your comments on the outside. I'm going to have to go back home into the garden. I'm such an idiot because I forgot to download all your comments, put them on a Word document or whatever it is to read them on this, so I can't do it. I'm so looking forward to doing it and all. I'm going to have to go into the Garden of Death now, and the reason why it's called the Garden of Death is because, you know, the cat, it's caught a squirrel yesterday. Caught a squirrel. And the squirrel looked dead, but it won, it lived. Well, it sort of scuttled off. And we don't know if it's alive or dead. But one thing we do know is that my idea of doing Sunday Outside in Ravenscourt Park is dead. Because by the time I've converted it all over into a document for it to read on here, there's going to be absolutely no time to do it. I'm such an idiot. This is not the same squirrel, it's just another squirrel. There is absolutely loads of squirrels. So the thought of one being dead is no great loss. Sad, but not devastating. I'm so annoyed with myself. I even brought a drink and tissues. I was perfectly prepared for everything, except for the main thing of your comments. I'm such a derpy doofus. Who leaves broken glass on the path where kids or dogs might tread, or even fully grown adults, and injure themselves? There's a bin right there. Ooh. I think that squirrel might have actually lived, because I'm sure I can hear it squawking in the background. Like that. I'll do this one here, but I think what I've done is opened all the videos in separate windows, so that I can go back to Ravenscourt Park. But let's do Sunday Outside in the Garden of Death, shall we? I can't see any dead squirrel. I mean, it had run off, so anyway. Soprano Pictures has put, I like the t-shirt, Charlie. Nice colours, looks like Teddy Fresh, H3H3 YouTuber fashion line. I can't remember what t-shirt I was wearing. I'm actually on the right video here. Am I on Sunday Outside comments here? Yes, I am, yeah. I can't remember what t-shirt I was wearing last week on Sunday Outside. This is a new one, what I'm wearing. But apart from this and the one that I wore yesterday, and the Dead Bod t-shirt that I wore on last week's car marks that I don't like, or that I do like, that was a new t-shirt, but I wear the same things all the time. I'm not a big shopping person, surprisingly enough. Icefish has put, I watch you, Charlie, as you have such a diverse range of videos that there is something for every person, or even the mood I'm in. Great work, keep it up, and the haters love stirring the pot on the tube of you. I love the terminology. You know when people say you're staring it? I always actually do think of a big wooden spoon in a big pot, like a cauldron. No. Almost a witch's laugh parrot, but not quite. Shane Hall has put, I've seen photos of private ambulances in Shepherd's Bush and places like that. I can remember Amy Winehouse being taken in a private ambulance, as well as Alexander McQueen when they passed away. I find private ambulances odd, as they're meant to be private, but it draws attention, as most people know the ambulances for dead people. I liked it when you said that the VW Beetles, as I hate them as well, horrible, ugly things. I like to picture what vehicles would be like if they were people. I think Audi would be rude, narcissistic, and a bit of a poser, as Audi cars are quite attractive. I think some buses would be rude and arrogant as well, as they can be quite rude vehicles, beeping at old ladies and cutting up people. However, I don't have anything against buses, as there might be positives. For example, for the buses saved their passengers in the crash in Birmingham. Do you ever, does anyone remember them buses where the back window looked like a big grinning face? It looks like a big smiley face. That was weird. Little of a bed Smith has put, "Hope you're okay, Charlie. Those Val trolls trying to defend Val Vanessa are clearly as horrible as her." Exactly. "How can anyone defend someone who is a proven liar and also thinks it's okay to dump her rubbish and let some other poor sap clear it up for her? Disgusting, and I wouldn't give her any time of day. Not worth it. You carry on being fabulous." Well, thank you very much. Exactly. I can't remember. Yes, the video of the Vanessa, you know, the series, there is a few people who are picking holes in the video, and there are a few people who are defending Vanessa, and it's just like, she's fly-tipped a load of rubbish. I mean, you can only assume that the people who defend her and are picking holes in the video are people who live like that, surely. Do you know what I mean? We like to wallow in their own filth, and then they have such an overflow of it, they've got to fly tip it somewhere else. I mean, they can't just put it in the bin for the bin men to collect. You know, very weird. Jan Brandon's put, "I'd say Jeffrey the giraffe is now probably a junkie." Soprano Pictures has put, "Oh, the hair, it's so long. It is. It's nice to run my fingers through it whilst I can, because there's going to be a day when it's all just going to be bald and no hair growth will be there." Soprano Pictures went on to say, "I like the t-shirt, Chad. The nice colours, looks like Teddy Fresh." Getting deja vu there. Can't remember what t-shirt I was wearing. Pardon, last week. I had to click back onto the thumbnail. Sloppy Turtles put, "Charlie is menopausal this weekend. Gallery Pig looks frightfully grumpy old man. You need to hydrate. Is the ginger cat still a random garden visitor?" Well, yes, except it's now a garden killer kitty. Well, I've said a billion times, the squirrel survived. It ran off somewhere. Probably to die. No, who cares? There's loads of squirrels. I know it sounds heartless, but when they're all squawking in the morning, I do like squirrels, obviously, but there's billions of squirrels. And it's just a natural thing in life, isn't it? Is the ginger cat still a random gather visitor? I like... See, so they just make a racket. So well behaved. When you say sit, he stays. Damn Dr. Ew. Never seen Star Wars or any of that. Not interested. I know, it's not potato. Not bothered about Star Wars. And Rebecca Trafford has put, "Don't you have another platform, Ryan, to send an email to?" And then that was it. And that was the comments for Sunday Outside. Very short, this Sunday Outside. I think it's because I do the live live chat thing, don't I? I've got some ring things so that I can do all this. Look, that was a bit brave of me. Can imagine if the sticky field had just like collapsed onto the floor and broke. But I put two on the back of it so that I've got extra control, because I thought one wouldn't be enough. More is always more. Right, yeah, so that's Sunday Outside comments. Let's see if I can go to Ravenscourt Park now, and let's see what I did on here works. So I need to go back. Probably not, isn't it? I don't think it's going to work. Because I still keep having to press back. Well, let's go find out. And I'm back. And what the difference, just maybe about 20 minutes makes, is some sort of upper class keep fit malarkey going on where they're just running backwards and forwards. And they've probably paid for that in the park. Very weird. Anyone can shout now, run from that coat to that coat. Very stupid. Anyway, let's see if this has worked. Oops, I've readjusted my things on the back. I love this. I don't know why I didn't do this earlier. Please work. The next video is plant water. 8 comments. Oh, so far so good. Sonia's put, "I've seen this in Boots. I won't be buying it now. It doesn't sound nice." Yeah, the plant plus, what was it called? Plant what? Oh, obviously it's gone off now. Oh, plant plus water. It was very, very pretentious. It wasn't as good as where it sounds or looks. Stop a Turtle's put, "Plant plus water review. Here I thought you decided to taste various plants in the garden on a rainy day. Yes. Yes, sloppy turtle. I'm just going to eat a random leaf off of a tree. I'm just going to eat a piece of grass on a piece of green that probably a dog's done its business on, or that in fact of a squirrel, you know. Raptor 24 Jill has put, there will be no bargains by Christmas for 29p. Exactly, Raptor 24 GL. There definitely will be. I can imagine them being no bargains. Proper, like, bulk stocked onto a shelf as well. Shane Olds put, they look okay, but that's it. I guess it's reasonably interesting. Yeah, I mean, obviously they attracted me to buy them. I mean, obviously I had to buy Boots meal deals, three Boots meal deals, because that was the only way I was going to get them for a reasonable price. There was no way I was paying £1.79 for a bottle of water. Natasha Evans has put, I bet you ate that really hot curry. I've not eaten that curry yet, no. I do need to do that YouTube video though. It's probably going to be a Tuesday reviews day one. I mean, the burgers was done on the Tuesday, weren't they? Yen brand designed for people who drive Chelsea tractors, living in Chelsea and are called Chelsea. Exactly. Exactly. Oh, flipping heck. I bet them keep fit people over there are all Audi, Range Rover and whatnot drivers in the middle of like Chiswick and Ravenscourt Park, do you know what I mean? It's just like, you don't need any of those cars. You're in central London. By all means, get a nice car to nip about with, but you don't need a big, massive, huge, humongous car clogging up the road and just generally getting in everyone's way, turning without indicating. The Bohemian has put, it's just water for hipster vegans, I bet. It is a very pretentious water. And Black Dolphin 90 put, dirty dishwater drinks. dishwater. I love that phrase, as dull as dishwater. So squirrel just pulled the focus. There's so many squirrels. I'm pretty sure now the population of squirrels now beats the population of rats in London. I'm pretty sure it must do. Maybe squirrels eat rats. Maybe they've evolved. And it's going to get to the point where it's going to roll reversal and it'd be squirrels eating cats. There's a lot of squirrel talk in this video, isn't there? The next video is Carolina Reaper. Please comment below. Yes, they're there! Should we go for a background change? Let's go for a background change. You know what I'm going to do? Just turn the camera. Like that. There we go. We've got a new background now. And there. Oh gosh, it's so thin and tiny you can't actually see it on the camera. There's like a brand new solitary tree that's been planted. It's next to the big, almost dead looking one. And it is there. So in this video, it was, what are we on now? Oh, the Carolina Reaper Bear, because this was the Tuesday reviews day. Flipping heck. It was so painful. The coughing and just like, oh, the stinginess. Pardon me. Bonzo's said, genius Simpsons quote, man, only discovered your channel today, keep up the good work. Oh, thank you very much, Bonzo. Oh yeah, I mean, you can't do a YouTube review of burgers without referencing steamed hams, surely, you know? And doing Simpsons quotes. I thought we were having steamed hams. And you call them steamed hams, except for the fact they're obviously grilled. Yes. It's an Albany expression. And Aurora Borealis! I think that's such a great way to shout it at Aurora Borealis. George Bignelli, how long have you been with Sherlock for? You too cute. Don't do schmaltz on the YouTube channel. No. If you're on that kind of behaviour, go to Fluffy Buns. Fluffy R channel. Don't exist. But, yeah. Sonia's put, I hope you and Sherlock are okay after eating those. Yes, we both lived. We both lived. And without the need of medical assistance. Ice22 put, my brother doesn't find them hot enough. Well, I think maybe it depends how you cook them. Because I did him a George Foreman grill, which wasn't listed on the in cooking instructions. It just said either shallow fry them or shove them under the grill. And I think what happened was I vaporised the chilies. And that's what was making us cough and like Nate Vick put, start doing mukbang, make your channel longer and get better lighting, eat and talk and put mukbang in the title and your channel will grow and you'll make a lot of money. Nate Vick, the reason why, there's a few reasons that are probably wrong in lots of many people's eyes. Unless YouTube do it automatically, of course, I don't put mid-roll adverts in my videos. I don't pressure people with things like Patreon and this, that and the other. I just want to make a YouTube video that hopefully people will watch. And hopefully they'll watch the first advert and maybe the one at the end of the video if they're watching multiple videos of mine. And that's it. I'm not... Obviously, it's nice to make money, but at the same time, I like to respect the viewer a bit more because some YouTube channels just put far too much adverts into their videos. And then before the videos even started, they'd be like, oh, be sure to subscribe and blah, 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 and there's our Patreon and this video is brought to you by Grammarly. Oh, I hate Grammarly so much. Every time you click on a YouTube video, it's Grammarly this, Grammarly that. No, you should have paid more attention in school. Okay, and writing is easy. I hate the adverts so much, Grammarly. Writing isn't easy. This is correct, but it's wordy. Yeah, maybe it's wordy because someone's trying to make an essay where it's got to contain 10,000 words. So of course they're gonna put it is instead of it's, and this, that, and the other. Grammarly just, I don't understand people would need to buy Grammarly. You know, I don't think Grammarly's going to teach you very well anyway because it's American. And another thing that bugs me about Grammarly is that one of the adverts, I was watching it and it says, Grammarly picks up errors. I was like, Grammarly picks up what? And I didn't hear what it said. And it was only about the fourth time I've seen the YouTube advert of Grammarly going errors. I was like, what's an errors? Errors? Oh, errors. Errors. That's what it is. I can't even... It's just like... I don't want to be told how to spell by people who've got bad diction. And I know it's an American accent. But and pick one that's going to sell your products. Grammarly can pick more than just errors. Errors. It's like, that sounds like a creaking garden gate, doesn't it? Errors. Error. There's R's in that word. Even error. An error. 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 Even when you say it poshly, you can still hear the R's. Error. But errors. Errors. What's an error? Anyway, I'm going so much about that. Lizzie Warren's foot. When I saw the thumbnail at first glance, I thought they were rustlers. They do look a bit rustlery. You're right, you are right. Oh, there's an accent on the I'm not going to pronounce this right. Fearag Forsyth, but your reaction was like mine at New Year when someone let off some sort of gas canister in Berlin U-Bahn I was travelling on. Took a couple of days to recover. That's just obscene. Why would somebody do such a thing? That's just ridiculous. RCP put, this was great. I'm glad it was great to watch because it certainly wasn't great to do. Just like, it's very, very painful. Laura's put, I'm in stitches at this. Same response as the video before. Richard Muse has put, I love this. Made them in buns and I put sriracha chili sauce on top. I want to buy more. Also, if you think this is bad, don't buy the curry. The curry is bought and the curry will be reviewed. Just to see if it's as strong as last time. Dan Riley put, oh, Sherlock. Watch more of my videos. Housemate. I'm just giving the answer. I've just done myself out of several videos being watched by you now. Oh, well. Jan Brenner's put, a good Dutch oven. Olix before bed put, what a bloody drama queen. Alan Murphy 647 put, hi Charlie, can you do one of the hottest crisps or chili challenge? I don't think so. I'm not really into spicy food. The premium's put, I'll pass on these, been a vegetarian for 30 years. Have you tried the plant burgers? I'm sure if I've missed a video if you have. I'm guessing you have a chili and ginger allergy. Hope you feel better soon, Charlie. I don't think I've done another vegetarian burgers, no. Although I have had the Linda McCartney ones, but I want a YouTube video. Bloody Smegs on the Blinks said Ryan Favre doing Gimme 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 reference. Slipper Turtles put all that cough in, smoke and bad smells. This should have been called Carolina Reefer Burger Review. Did you open some? Some sort of unscreened windows, dear boy? Vent that stink outdoors. Yes, Slippy Turtle. We don't have screens on our windows. Michael Hawkins has put, why so many dislikes? I don't know, and it all counts as engagement, so whoever thinks they're being clever, they're really not. And Steely 666 has put, the curry is supposed to be the artist. I will be doing the curry. And Jonathan Reyes has put, don't go into the kitchen! Oh god, yeah, going into the kitchen was just absolutely shocking. Next video was... Surprise! Flying Tiger Copenhagen, the surprise bags is the next video. Shall we go for another background change? Let's do that. And they're just going to swivel the camera this time. Let's go somewhere different. Here we are. Possibility of seeing some wildlife in the background. There is a squirrel just going along the... chops down logs there. Should we do a 360? Let's do a 360. Then you'll see the crow. There's the crow look. And over there are some people walking and jogging. There's that tree I told you about. Yes. There we are. That was a nice 360, wasn't it? Hopefully that'll come across nicely on YouTube, otherwise it'll be all blocky probably. Oh well. Next comments is, what was the video again? It was a surprise! Wasn't it? Exclamation mark. Where are we? There we are. Chloe Stewart put, I want one of them for Christmas, a mystery bag or box. Chloe Stewart, I want! Father Christmas doesn't come to people who want. No. Please, may I have? That's like the patronising teacher talk, isn't it? Shane Knowles put, I like the Flying Tiger logo. The T with its eyes looks like Clippy. Oh, yeah, the little paperclip off of Microsoft. Has had babies with a letter T, lol. The notepad looks good, as well as the pen and the headphones, but the items are not really my thing. No, but I still consider that bag to be more than what the HMV bag was. Box. Ryan V put, YouTube doesn't like ball messages, deleted more comment. Oh yeah, that does lead me on to the fact that stupid seagulls bog off back to the seaside. Flippin' heck. Actually, I shouldn't disrespect the seagulls because they might poo on me right now and flying overhead. Anyway, yes. I do endeavour to read out everyone's comments. If I leave anyone out, I'm very sorry. There's a man who's just suddenly decided in the middle of the field to do press-ups. Well, he's got up now. Oh, no, he's going to do sit-ups. In the middle of the field. Oh, yep, the dog just goes dump right into him. I can't do any of that, you know. It's funny, I know it's ironic, but I'd feel so self-conscious doing press-ups and sit-ups in the middle of a park, even though I'm in the middle of the park doing this. It doesn't make sense, I know, but I just think it looks a bit ridiculous. Just like, what are you doing? Go home and do that. I'll go to a part of the park where it's more acceptable. Anyway, yeah, I do try to read out everyone's comments. What's for tea's put? Love the plastic cups and straws. I imagine they'll be coming handy for a few drinks review videos. Exactly, yeah. Bargain at £5 for all that. It really was. I was really impressed with the amount of stuff in there. Sonia's put, the surprise bag is really good. I'm thinking about getting one. And as you said, it's much better than the HMV boxes you had. Exactly. Lizzie Warren has put, very cute is the pop-up cake. Birthday for me, lol. As it was my birthday yesterday. And that was on Wednesday. So happy birthday for Tuesday gone, Lizzie. And loads of people wished you happy birthday as well, which is nice. Now let's go to the next video, which was thoughts for Sunday outside. Oh, I just pressed the cross twice then. I shouldn't do that. Just in case something goes wrong. What did I do for this? That's Sunday outside. Oh yeah, was you ever bothered about Halloween? Gosh, that plane's low. Look at that. It's like proper nose down. Can you see it?
Can you see it? Or is it just going to be weighted out by the clouds?
I don't know.
Hopefully you saw it. Put that on there like that. Yeah, Halloween! We see, when I say Halloween, it sounds like Calla. Halloween. It's just some sort of... sounds like some sort of religion, doesn't it? Lindsay Knight has put, taking my daughter out for a birthday treat on Monday, and I'm taking some food with us for the trips, and I've packed up a pack up for these each. Looking forward to trying them. They look lovely. Oh, yeah, because I also at the time reviewed them Halloween sweets, didn't I? What the flipping heck are you talking about, Lindsay? Yeah, I tried the McVitie's Jaffa cakes, didn't I? The ones with black currant in as well. Yeah, there was really nice, by the way. Yeah, I totally forgot that was part of the video. Oh, I'm salivating now because it was actually that good. It was nice and sharp. Very tart, as I like to say. Ryan Favre has put, I loved Halloween as a child. The school party was always a treat, a great highlight of the year. I don't know where I got the word treat from then. As an adult, it's a bit of a laugh. We normally have a family fancy dress party or we'll go out with a few friends. I was planning on dressing up as Linda this year. Woohoo if there was put an end to that. Oh, what a shame. Yeah, I mean, growing up for me, we didn't do Halloween at all. At all, no one did. And it wasn't just because we were northerners and no one had the money to bloody dish out sweets willy-nilly. It just wasn't a thing. And it's definitely within the last 15 years, it's become more of a thing. I do remember going out on a night out with friends and everything once. And we did an Halloween theme and we dressed up. But that was it. I didn't feel any connection to it whatsoever. It was just an excuse to dress up for fancy dress. But as adults, really. But it was boring, you know, really. I mean, there was no other theming going on at all in any of the pubs. Jennifer Reese has put, I ain't bothered, sir. that's amazing because I understand, obviously, Jonathan, that you're in America. And I always assume, I always link automatically Halloween with America. Always. Dwoof has put, no, I blame the woohoo. Who fly. I don't know how to pronounce your name and I don't know what you said. I tried to read it out. I'm very, very sorry, but I always try. It's Shane Hall has put, good atmospheric video. The music sort of sounds me, good atmospheric video. The music sounds sort of like some of the organ sounds you get in Westminster Cathedral, Victoria. Yes. So yeah, do try my best to read everyone's comments. Even if I can't actually speak. Rex24GL put, no, not at all. I think it's in the last 10 years it started to grow in popularity. Yeah, exactly. And I think pound shops and Wilkinson's and the supermarkets helped, didn't they? Because obviously it was a way of making that extra bit of money just before Christmas. And in the UK we have got Bonfire Night, which is significant enough, but Halloween has sort of taken quite a lot of the thunder away from it, which is annoying. Because I like Bonfire Night more, and it's a great reason just to burn a load of stuff you don't want. And there's fireworks, and there's, Bonfire Night's great. People call it different things. Some people call it Guy Fawkes Night. I don't. I think people call it Guy Fawkes Night. Are very posh people. Yes, I think. Because the primary school that I went to, some of the posher kids that went there called it Guy Fawkes Night. Some of the teachers. Okay, Danny's, but honestly, kind of not bothered about Hallows, really. If not this year, at least. It's just kind of ugh these days here. Let's have a good one, but I suppose the number one rule of Hallows is always have sweets ready. If you don't want eggs thrown, you see, we don't do any of that rubbish either. Throwing eggs and toilet roll around, especially this year. Who's going to be doing that this year? That'd be quite interesting, wouldn't it? Can you imagine all those idiots who bulk bought all that toilet roll are now going to waste it on Halloween? Best get some. I can imagine an evil way to get some sweets is get a glove, perfect time really, get some sticky tape, Gorilla tape, and put a small bit in the glove in the palm of your hand. When they come and get a couple out the basket, reach out and put your sweets in the basket. No, I think what I'd do is, I'd have all the sweets floating
on the top of like some really stinky goo. So it looks like they can grab some sweets, but as soon as they're going to reach them, there's like a stinky, gloopy mess of like rancid eggs or something like that. Yeah. Went on to say it's called Trick or Treat for a reason. Yeah, so yeah, take whatever, just not my dark side Skittles. They're all for me. Get off. That's actually, there's a fly on me on then. That was weird. I hope it was a fly anyway, not something scary like was a, them two little night flies whizzing around my head. That was weird. And also unnecessary for, fuck off. I smell nice. By the way, anyway, you know it is, I had a shower. As I do every day, sometimes twice, because I swear calls. Yes, good review. Thank you very much, Kay Danny. Lizzie Warren has put, not really been bothered about Halloween. No parents didn't want people knocking on doors or treating, and I had no brothers or sisters to safely go around with. I was happy with watching Treehouse of Horror Simpsons and eating sweets. Yeah, I do. That's the only positive. I do like the Halloween Simpsons episodes. The press-up guy has just suddenly moved down to near the tree. Should we go in for a look? Who cares? It's in a public place. I mean, you get what you deserve, don't you? He's now near the tree. He's moved under a tree, which is not a wise thing to do because he might do a press-up and a bird might poo on him. He's not thought on, has he? No. He should have gone behind the tree so I wouldn't have seen him. When I was 18, I went to an Halloween party which had adults and children all dressed up and a costume, but that was it. Yeah, Halloween's just not that. And going knocking on strangers' doors as well. I mean, that's just asking for danger, isn't it? Because you don't know whose door you're knocking on. And that was all the comments. Thank you very much on that. Sugar. No, what have I done? No internet. I know I've got no internet. I don't want the internet. I just want to read people's comments. The next video, oh, funny enough, goes on to the Jimmy Savile thing that the BBC are making. Why on earth they're doing that, I have no idea. As I said in the video, I'm talking about knocking on strange people's doors. You don't know whose door you're knocking on. It could be a Jimmy Savile supporter, couldn't it? Yeah, flipping Halloween. It's just stupid. Go around to a friend's house, have a house party if you have kids and this, that and the other. But don't let your kids knock on strangers' doors like that. It's, unfortunately, no. Just don't do that. Jan Brand put, sad to say, people would watch this in the droves. Basically, it would be clickbait. That's what the BBC has become. I'm really disgusted with the BBC for thinking that they have the right to make something so... You don't need to know of these people, do you really? You just need to know of them being captured and dealt with by the authorities. And yes, we don't want life stories and the lives and times of these people. Absolutely not. The PMU was put, Jimmy Savile was buried in an unmarked grave. His stone was removed and destroyed. I do remember the when it was all coming out in the news, and in Scarborough, where he was buried, they said they was going to remove his gravestone at a certain time, but they actually sort of lied and just took it away that same night because the new people was going to go there and destroy it. And like anyone would have cared, but it was right that they took it away quickly because if it had been damaged and someone had gone near it and got injured, you know. Hill Rose, but absolutely no way should it be made. That man should not be given any airtime at all. Exactly. Do they not realise they're glorifying it? Jonathan Reyes says, but I don't know what you're talking about, so I want to watch it. You won't want to watch it if you actually Google who he is. Jonathan. Jamie Smith has put, summit for old Rolf to watch while he plays with his didgeridoo. Oh, flipping heck, yeah, the Rolf Harris connection as well. Oh, can he guess what it is yet? Yeah, prison cell for you, Rolf. Oh, God, it was such a bad time. Steeler666 has put, be cool to see. Really? Are you just trolling me? And Rebecca Trafford put, vile. Darren Wilkinson's put, you're right, the BBC must need the reds testing. Maybe the public should boycott the licence fees if this goes ahead. Or force it to go commercial. The rubbish they show isn't worth it. EastEnders hasn't been good for years. I totally agree with you that this is disgusting and in bad taste. Exactly. Exactly. Who are they thinking
is going to watch this and who do they think is going to appreciate this thing being made? The only thing I'm intrigued to know is what sad, workless actor is going to pick up the baton of playing the character of Jimmy Savile. It is in bad taste. It really is. It's completely tasteless, actually. I can't imagine anyone wanting to watch it. Slobber Turtles, but television is dead. If you weren't wasting your time on that crap, you would have to you'd have to see that. It's akin to looking at a nude 90-year-old. It's just disgusting, isn't it? Well, obviously, I think I'd rather watch a nude 90-year-old than flipping watch anything of that Jimmy Savile malarkey. I can't imagine why they would do it. It's just so stupid. And the last video is another... Let's go for another background. Mr. Exercise Man's disappeared. Unless he's behind the factory. I don't know. Let's go for another background change for the last comments. There's a duck on a tree. Well, a goose, whatever it is. It just thinks it's so clever because it's in a tree. Look, it's like, look at me, I'm in a tree. Can you actually see it? Yeah, you can. I think it's too scared to jump down. Its friends have all wandered off. That is funny. What a racket. Do you think it thinks it's stuck? Quack, 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 quack. Quack, 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 quack. Yes, yes. I'm Dr. Doolittle, I can talk to the animals. It's just like random goose in a tree. I think I need to move on because I'm still in the middle of a path here and I'm in people's way. Your friend is in a tree. Are you not going to help? You're not very nice friends, are you? Are you family? Yes. I have just told off 5 geese. They're not geese, are they? What are they? What are you?
I don't know what they are.
Ah, there's a goose. Yes. Christmas dinner, maybe. Nah, prefer turkey. There's a couple of pigeons there masquerading as some sort of bird you might want to feed bread to, but no, I will not. I won't be fooled by a couple of pigeons. Shh! It's too loud! Squawking like that. Is that a seagull squawking? I think it is. Oh, look, the goose is coming out the pond. Oh, it yawned! It's a tired goose. All the geese and the ducks are following me. I don't have any food. I don't have anything for you. I don't have anything for you. Look at them all, they're just all coming to me. Maybe I am Dr. Doolittle. Because I'm doing nothing right now. I'm just going to read the rest of your comments. I'm reading comments from subscribers. I am not feeding... But I can't look at them all. They're all coming to me. Hello. You're all going to be so annoyed when I don't give you any food. I haven't got anything. I don't have anything. Why are they all coming to me? I don't have anything. They're all just staring me out now. They're all going to get so cross when I walk away. Well, I can't read comments. I can't read out YouTube comments whilst I'm being watched by all these avian specimens. There's even a pigeon that's come to me. Oh, God, go away! Oh, look. They're all starting to swim away now. Yeah, look, they've all gone away now. They're all very annoyed with me. Right. I need a background to read the... What happened there? Something landed. Right. Comments from... Oh, I'm on a hill now. I can't read out your comments. Hang on a minute. Let me just get to this top of the hill. Oh, it's like a billion more geese. It's like a goose farm. And there's one of them leggy beds. I don't know what they're called. It's not a moorhen, I know that. But it's quite leggy. Oh, there's another one of them. There's a few of them. I don't know what they're called. Just enjoy the background. A couple of palm trees. Well, three, aren't they? Right. I can't put my camera down on such a hill. Can I? That's a, maybe if I pick my pack up. Is that going to fall? It's going to fall. Oh, and now the squirrels are coming to me. Hello. I really don't have anything. I seem to be attracting all the wildlife today. I don't have anything. I really don't have anything. Is this the beginning? Is this where the animals take back the planet away from the humans? Right, is my camera going to stand here? Yes, it will. Good. I won't be able to rest my bag on the tripod. Let me have a bit of a drink. I was a bit worried there. Right, another 10 car marks that I like, hate, not bothered about. Ooh, lots of comments. Oh, 14. Sloppy Turtle put Toyota. Nissan. Used to be known as reliable, but now are mostly crap as the company they are in deep doo-ga-doo. Nurses Yuki or Vauxhall in the US, Charlie? It's Nurses Yuki in the US. I knew there'd be no Vauxhall. Vauxhall is, well, used to be, I think, owned by GM of America. And Vauxhall and Opel was just marks that they used in Europe and the UK. No Suzuki or Vauxhall in the US, Charlie. Charlie, I like that we judge cars the same way based on how cute it is, lol. Remember Abfab when Adina got a smart half car? It is. Some title went on to say they just want to buy a car that goes somewhere. Amen. Enough said. Tesla is awesome. Oh. Eat your words, Charlie. I'm very scared and angry now, lol. You're walking past all these no doubt expensive townhouses, yet oh, they all look the same. There's no garage or driveway. I'm sorry, I just can't. I need a garden and a garage. Exactly. Because most of the UK was built before America existed. That is why. Shane always put, liked the Vauxhall Astra from 2005 to 2009, as well as the Corsa, as it looked smiley and happy, lol. Tesla is an interesting car, but I think it can make any car clever by installing the Google Assistant. I love the Renault Megane, and with the similar design to the one in the video. Yeah, I like the Renault Megane, the first style of it when it came out. St. John's Ambulance used to use them, which made them even more, probably saved hundreds of lives. I love Bentleys, they are beautiful. I apologise for the grammar. I had a few Guinnesses. Shane Hall. But I do like Bentley cars. Now, I know that footballers buy them a lot, but generally they are a chauffeur-driven car, or people who just ooze and just want quality of a car. You get a Bentley. I like Bentley. Twingo Driver said safe again. Well, there's always part three. I've only covered 21 car marks now, haven't I? And some big brands I've still not done. And there's a very good reason for that as well. There's some marks there that you were expected to have covered by now that I haven't. But all will be explained. Ryan V has put, oh, thank goodness the stubble is back. Just laziness, really. And also as well, my skin is very sensitive. I'm going to do a proper full-on wet shave. My skin just goes red raw. Rebecca Trafford has put, here we go again, Jeremy bloody Clarkson. my name, Jeff Productions, put, Charlie Poo reveal. What a comment. Bettina has put, Ford. There's a good reason why I've not done Ford yet. There generally is. And you'll see when I do the part three of the video, or another 10. Jan Brenner's put, nah, teachers drive micros.
When I was at school, they all drove them Volvo estate cars, and I can't remember what number it was now, because Volvo don't really do names of cars, do they? It's usually just a number. But you know them really long estate cars that Volvo made? There's always about four or five of them in the teacher's car park. West Ham GSB out Dalek has put, my sister has a Vauxhall Astra, I've got a Yaris. Well, I've already given my opinions of those car marks who make the Yaris and the Astra. Ewan Southern 212 has put, wow, I love cars, but it's your opinion. Yes, of course, I've just got an opinion. It's just like, when I decide to drive, I will be getting a car of a mark that I like, as I'm sure most people do. Unless you're a Vauxhall driver, where you're just getting a car to get from A to B, and you have no want for quality, no want for design, and you're just wanting a very basic, movable piece of metal on four wheels. That's quite harsh, and it's a Vauxhall and Vauxhall drivers, but it's true. They're just not very stylish cars. Hail Rose, but Toyota aren't as reliable as they used to be. I don't like Fiat at all. They would be the last car I'd choose. Nissan, the Qashqai, I always call it Qashqai or Squish Squash, is my favourite of them. Volkswagen, Skoda, Audi are my favourite. Well, Hail Rose, I sort of presumed that because your profile picture is of the VW logo. And that's all the comments. Thanks everyone for watching Sunday Outside. I know I've been a bit disjointed this week. I've been all over the place, but hopefully you've enjoyed it. We've seen animals, and we've seen many different backgrounds, and I've talked to all sorts. Yes, anyway, thanks for watching Scrass Bellamy. Bye. I just got washing land by some kids with a dog on an extendable lead. It's so annoying, why do you get these things on camera? I'm still laughing at myself. I was like, ah!